going through the hives this morning and I come across this smaller unit, and it's got me a little bit puzzled. It's a brood infection going on inside, but it's not European fallow brood. The infection is killing the brood after the capping stage, and I was a little bit concerned that it's starting to throw red flags for American fallow brood. So I didn't really know what to do. So what I did is I called Derek Micholson and asked if he was in the area here, if he could come by, take a look, and just give me a little bit of feedback and reflection on what's going on within this hive. So Derek was more than gracious. He was in the area actually he was sampling for other beekeepers, I guess, in the area. So he slipped by and he's gonna provide me a little bit of feedback on what's going on within this colony. So Derek, thanks for coming to the farm again.
Good to be back.
I wonder what we'll do is we'll go down and, but I want to pull a frame. As you can see, the colony is weak and failing and quite sickly. And what I'm concerned about is this colony has fallen victim to American fallow brood, but it's not showing all the symptoms of American fallow brood. So I want you to take a look at the brood and maybe help diagnose the issue with it.
Sure. Do you know if it's on every frame or?
Yeah, it's basically all these brood frames here.
Yeah, you can definitely see that right in there. Now, yeah. So with both American fallow brood and sac brood, beekeepers often confuse these two diseases because they show very similar symptoms. So the larva will die after the cell is capped, and basically, yeah, the larva will die and turn discolored, start off as light brown and kind of get more and more brown as the disease progresses. Now, if we look, don't have a hive tool on, but a marker, we just kind of uncap this cell a bit. Now, you can see the larva is kind of standing straight up. The end of the larva is kind of pointy. The head is towards the top. Now, this is very indicative of sac brood disease. Sac brood disease is a viral disease that it typically shows up more so in the springtime, in periods of increased stress, you know, temperature stress and nutritional stress, more so in the springtime. Most of the time, the bees will be able to clear it out on their own, especially if it's a nice strong colony, younger queen, and you know, if the hive's doing really well, they can just take care of it on their own.
So what's telling you that's sac brood and not American fallow brood then?
Yeah, so with American fallow brood, basically the larva turns into kind of a mush. Now, if we took a stick.
Piece of grass here somewhere.
And a good stick on the ground.
There we go.
Now, if we take a stick and with American fallow brood, the larva will, you know, rope out. So this would be the ropey test, and you just kind of mush that larva around. And with American fallow brood, that would really rope out. And in this case, this is not happening. The larva is just kind of turning into a watery kind of, it's a lot more watery than American fallow brood would be.
Yeah.
And so we can try it on another larva as well, and that's not happening there either. Now, what you could do,
so it's indicative for American fallow brood to rope out then.
American fallow brood would rope out and pull out, you know, at least a centimeter, sometimes 2 centimeters, right out.
Oh, okay.
And so with sac brood, the larva, the inside of the larva kind of turns into this watery mush, but the skins of the larva will actually stay fairly intact, and you could just pull it right out. If I had a pair of tweezers, it might work better, but.
So the bees could actively pull that out.
And just kind of pull it out, and basically the whole thing stays intact. And it is kind of this kind of sacky.
Yeah, I see what you mean.
Which is why it's called sac brood.
Okay, so I can rest a little bit easy then.
So I would say you could rest easy. This
looks certainly infected. This is, so what should I do? Like, this colony obviously is, I'm just going to get rid of it.
Yeah, now usually the recommendation is if you're only seeing it on a couple cells, wouldn't be too concerned about it. The bees would usually be able to take care of that on its own. If you're starting to see it in, you know, more than 5 to 10 cells on a frame, or 5% of your actual comb, you would then need to take some steps to deal with it. A frame like this, just because it's quite infected, there's quite a few cells on here. My general recommendation would just be just to get this right out.
Burn it just to get it out.
Yeah, just to be on the safer side, just get it out. And, you know, it's just a couple frames from your entire operation. Yeah. Another thing that you can do is just to requeen it. Get some better genetics in there. Certain genetics are more susceptible to these diseases. And just changing out the queen, getting something in there with maybe a little bit more hygienic behavior. And kind of did a video yesterday with Ian looking at testing for hygienic behavior and utilizing those good hygienic genes in your colonies can really help the bees to be able to clean out these infections a lot better.
All right, yeah. So hygienic behavior helps with all these types of brood diseases also.
Absolutely, yeah.
So a good hygienic nest with lots of bees, they would have that all cleaned up and I wouldn't even have known there's an issue.
Yeah, I would say, yeah, good strong colony with some of those hygienic genes, you probably wouldn't even see it in your colony.
Okay, that is actually good news. I was kind of fretting maybe it was American fallowbrood and I'd have to take some steps to be able to mitigate a potential problem that might have been happening in front of my eyes. But so that's the reason why I brought Derek out, just to confirm that I didn't have an infection festering and just to diagnose the issue, and more information is better. So thanks for coming out, Derek. I know you kind of went out of your way to slip by the farm again, but very much appreciated.
Not a problem.